Recently, I read an article. Article said, fading glory of Indian pharmaceutical industry. I just started thinking, what is it? Is it happening by design or is it by the crisis? When I look at the entire scenario, and I thought that I think the first principle we must really take into account in our industry, that is, we should not waste time at this moment during the period of crisis. Let's not waste time at all. Let's start working on for or against or for or betterment of our own self. And then we look at the crisis as part of our business. There are definitely six ways to really look at how do we really deal with the crisis. Now there is differently a way to look at the therapeutic areas in which we are in, the patient segment and the doctor segment which we are in, also the new products and new drugs which are coming, similarly the patented medicines which are coming and also the generics which are coming. So it's a kind of crisis from debranding, crisis from demonetization, crisis from GST, crisis from even the generics which are coming up, and you are all aware that what's happening to US and also US generics. Mylan, Teva, these are the biggest companies of generics, are looking at different models themselves. Business models are changing. So obviously we need to look at what are our strengths and what is our new business model. That's the first way which we can look at what are our strengths, which therapy areas are our strengths, which target segments are our strengths, which target therapies are our strengths, where are the products which are really lying with us, and so enhance them with the kind of focus which we will make on therapy areas, the stakeholders, and also the way we are going to do the business. That's a business model. Second way is to look at how digitalization has taken place. How do we really connect ourselves in this disconnected world, which is more important. Recently, you'll find that Thomas Friedman, who has written a book on World is Flat, later on he looked at the business in a different way, and we have other business publications of his. Recently, he's trying to say about acceleration in the kind of business and the disconnectivity which is coming up. This book has marvelously given three principles. One, he said three ways you can really look at this crisis and work on that. One is the market. The market which is really forcing you to do what you need to do. All of you must imagine or should imagine that in the entire automobile industry, just one Maruti car made a difference. And all those Fiat or Ambassador or all those cars, when they were there during those time, they started really puzzling what's happening to the entire market. Just one small car from Suzuki. And you see the whole scene is changing. Similarly, you will find cinema as an industry. You found music as an industry. You will find earlier we used to pay for the music. Today we don't pay for the music. So in other words, digitalization which has taken place. And also the kind of Moore's law, which also Friedman says very clearly, Moore's law is a technology law. And every 24 hours, 28 hours, 48 hours, the law is changing, technology is changing, and also the prices are changing. Third part is a mother. And mother is a climate. What kind of climate you are in? So obviously these three principles of Thomas Friedman, like market, mother, and also the technology which is coming up with Moore's law. So three M's, which are important enough for us to really remember during crisis. So second way is to look at the crisis to ensure that we get connected and we connect these disconnected dots of patients, doctors, paramedicos, all other physical and other, let's say, devices which we have, diagnostics which we have, medical products which we have. How do we really connect entire thing and give a kind of care to the patients?